Welcome to another episode of RV Pro Tips. I'm Matt Arndt, and this is Matt Walkins, and the sun is shining in Indiana today. We've got a Montana SF1200i-L package here today, and we want to talk about how to operate it, how to get everything up and going. But first, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Sure. My name is Matt Walkins. I've been with a company called Future Solutions for about a little over 8 years. Been in the RV industry about 23 years, mostly focused on solar, power, off-grid power generation, kind of getting people outside, letting them boondock in their units has been my main focus. So
Matt's been integral in helping design and develop with our engineering department this system, and we'd like to have you show us how to get it going. I don't know anything. That's
sure.
Just like that.
Sure. So 1200 on a Montana fifth wheel, everything's going to be located up front. 3000 watt inverter, battery bank, lithium battery bank, inverter disconnect, and then here's your battery switch disconnect. So this is your 12 volt power for the inside the coach. We're going to turn on our battery disconnect, which is all the house loads and everything in there. We're going to turn on our inverter disconnect, which provides 12 volt power to the inverter so that you can have AC power inside. And then as you note here, here are all your serial numbers for your two solar chargers, solar charger one, solar charger two, the shunt, which is where you're going to monitor your 12 volt battery status at, and then your servo, which is servo, you can click this link, hook up to the Wi-Fi, and then you can read everything through Wi-Fi inside the coach as well.
So once you've got the unit up and running, Matt, I believe there's the Victron app that you'd need to download.
Yeah. So you're going to want to download the Victron Connect app. You'll open that up, look for local devices. So you can see a list of devices here. You'll see your name devices, and then you're going to want to click on that. It'll open that up, and then that tells me what's going on with my batteries. You can see I'm at 92%. I've got a 15 amp draw because I've got some lights on inside there, and I can run for approximately a day and 7 hours at the current status. So this is what you're looking for. So on this particular floor plan, your monitoring devices and your control devices are here in this one cabinet. So I've got here, this is my inverter. As you can see right now, it says the inverter's off. I turn that on, and you hear the microwave kick on, the fridge is trying to kick on, and you also see this system here telling you that you've got 25 amps available. If you roll through this, you'll see voltage on line one, voltage on line two. That's because this entire coach is inverted. This inverter here, it's telling you right now we're inverting, we're at 13.2 volts. So I've got my Victron app open. As you can see, I'm pulling 1,544 watts right now. My inverter says 109 amps, negative 109 amps. Now, obviously, negative 118. Negative 109. There's some other things running, some 12 volt loads that aren't on the AC right now. I've got 120 volts on leg two, 118 on leg one, and you can see that's how many amps my AC is pulling right now. So again, we're not plugged in, so everything's running off the inverter. So as you can see, we're inverting right now. In other words, I'm pulling 27 amps off the battery. I've got a fan running for the air conditioner. This is telling me I'm limited to 25 amps, and if you can see up here, this says I'm pulling about 43. That's DC plus AC loads. But you'll notice my charger light is not lit. There's nothing there lit up. The inverter light's on, charger light is off. So go ahead and plug her in. So you should see this. See that start flashing? So we just plugged into shore power right now. So it's going to take it about 20 seconds. And that's going to flash. If it feels like it's got good power, quality voltage, it's going to go ahead and let it go through. You'll see this switch from inverting. It'll stop to nothing, and then it's going to go to bulk charging. So now I'm charging. I'm putting in roughly 75 amps. So you can see this here. Now I've gone from negative 1,000 watts to positive 742 watts. So I'm charging right now. If at any point that light isn't lit and you're connected to shore power, that power is not making it to the inverter, and so you're not going to get any charge. You're just running off a battery. So that's one of the first places you need to look If you're having issues with your battery rundown, look for that light. That light needs to be on if you're plugged into shore power. Second thing is, if you look up here, this went from 25 amps to 30 amp service. Inverting, but you see the power was interrupted. My charger light came on telling you, oh, there's still power available, but the voltage wasn't very good. So that's gonna go, it'll, again, a long 20 seconds, that'll kick over to charging. And you'll see this device here, we've got it in. So here's what has happened, is we don't have good power. So I'm load supporting. That's one of the features of this inverter, is I have okay power, but I don't have great power. So I'm helping run loads. So if I shut some stuff off, go up here to my HVAC, and I turn this off. So you can see that the load has gone away. I have 0 amps because I've shut my air conditioner off. Now I'm bulk charging down here. My charger light is solid and I'm putting power in. And of course this is metering net. So you can see here, this 655 watts is what's going into the battery. If you get a question and you wonder, well, how come this says only 49 amps here and this says 65? It's because the rest of these lights are taking that extra difference in between.
All right, Matt. So it sounds like you've gotten that question many, many times.
Yeah.
One other thing that we haven't touched on yet, but battery heat for those lithium batteries.
Right. So the lithium batteries that you have in this system have internal heat. You don't need heat blankets. There's no exterior source that needs heat going down there. They are actually heated from the inside. But you need to be able to arm that. It's not on all the time and you don't want it on all the time. So here you have a switch that says battery heat. You can see when it's red, that means it's armed. Now it's 100 degrees in this building today, so there's no reason for that heat to run. And it won't run as it's sitting down there because it has an internal temperature monitor. So, but should it get down below 32 degrees, that heat will kick on and those will keep those batteries warm. Lithium batteries can go ahead and discharge. They'll keep running just like a lead acid will all the way down below freezing. What the difference is the BMS will not allow them to take a charge. So you have to have the internal temperature of their battery up for the solar to work and for some other things to happen, so.
Okay, great, good information. So Matt, it looks like we've gone through just about everything. So my 1200i-L SolarFlex package is up and running now.
Yep.
Everything's good to go. Yep. I just need to monitor my consumption, pay attention to what I'm doing.
Everything in here runs off that battery bank when you're not plugged in. Obviously we're plugged into shore right now, so we're charging, but yeah.
The Victron app, pay attention.
Watch your Victron app to look at your battery state of charge. You know, watch this. If you're plugged into shore, watch that. Make sure that you got a green light there on your charger side so you know you've got shore power coming in. And then if you have anything, this will, I mean, the precision circuit system will let you know if you've got a brownout or any kind of faults, anything like that. It's just a good way to monitor and kind of charge it. You have the ability to, as we call it, mooch docking. So you plug into 15 amp power or 10 amp power at somebody's house. You have the ability to set your power settings and your power consumption so you're not using more than that breaker will take, you know, to eliminate nuisance trips. So there's, I mean, everything in this coach is running off a battery. So yeah, it's a good system.
Let's head back on out. Yeah. Thanks. All right, Matt, thanks for showing us all of that. We got some questions though. What does a 1200i-L package come with?
On your Montana, a 1200i-L package, the 1200 refers to the solar wattage on the roof. So you've got four 300 watt panels on the roof. They come down through two docking ports and they come to dual 50 amp Victron smart solar chargers.
So you have two of those.
Two of those. And you'll find those on your device list. You'll see two of them named and they're also labeled on the front of the system there. Dragonfly Energy GC3 batteries, 270 amp hours each, so 540 amp hours of lithium battery. There is a 3000 watt Magnum 3012 RV hybrid inverter that is specifically designed to work with the lithium batteries, and it actually powers the entire rig. Everything in the coach can be run off the inverter. Now you can't necessarily run everything at the exact same time because you're limited to 25 amps of power, but every outlet on that unit is in an inverted outlet, so it's available when you're off grid. There's also a precision circuits energy management system. What that does is if something kicks on or you forget that you're running an air conditioner or you're running a microwave and somebody goes and starts a fireplace or plugs in something large, and you go over the amp limit of the inverter, it's gonna turn off load. So it'll start shutting stuff off to make sure that you're not, one, kicking out the batteries, or two, overloading the inverter. There's also a battery guardian on there from Precision Circuits. And what that does is that's an automatic disconnect. So when you hit your switch and you disconnect the coach, that sound you're hearing, that's that disconnect kicking on and off. But it will automatically shut off and not let you continue to run your batteries down when it gets to 11.6 volts.
Can I run my ACs off of the solar?
You can actually run them both, but you're not running them off the solar. So that's kind of a common misconception with solar. You're not really running anything off of the solar panels. You need three components in a good system to be able to run. You need a battery bank, which think of it like a fuel tank. You need an inverter capable of running those items. And then you need solar power. So the inverter is your drivetrain, it's your propulsion, it's your engine. The solar panels up on the roof are a pump at a filling station. So what they're doing is they're putting the energy into the battery bank. The battery bank, hopefully it's full and topped off. The inverter's taking the energy out of there and it's what's running your coach. So you've got 25 amps of power available through the inverter. So yeah, you can actually run both air conditioners at the same time off of your battery bank.
Positioning of the RV, your panels on the roof, they're stationary. They're not going anywhere. Well, how does that affect the unit and charging the batteries?
Sure.
All of that stuff.
So the way the system's designed, everything is a parallel system. You have two sets of panels, 600 watts each, two chargers, both charging the battery, and they're wired directly to the battery. So when you hit your disconnect, they still continue to work. The reason that we've done it that way is so if you're parked this large rig in a campground and the back half of your coach doesn't have any solar, it's not gonna affect the front half of the coach having solar. So there's some redundancies built in there. The idea is, and if we could get the sun to disappear because it's about 110 degrees in here, it would be fantastic, but that way the coach still operates, you still get something out of it. If you're in Indiana like we are, where we get lousy sun, we only get maybe at best 3 hours a day, you're not going to get that much energy out of the sun. It's peak time energy is what it's called. Watch your time remaining, watch your state of charge on your battery, and keep an eye on that stuff as you're running whatever it is you want to run.
Maintaining the solar system, is there anything special I need to do?
So with regards to the devices that are underneath that are actually in the coach, I mean, short of making sure that they've got airflow around them, that you're not blowing dust inside some of the components or anything like that, and you're keeping that area dry, there's not a whole lot you're going to do down here. When you're up on the roof, you want to make sure that you're just basically cleaning them off with water and a rag, and just toweling them dry. Best thing you can do, just use water on there and just wipe them dry. Second thing, don't hit a hot panel with cold water. So it is a glass panel. Its size is going to change a little bit with temperature, and you don't want to fracture that panel. And if a panel in Arizona, if it's 105 degrees in the desert, that panel could be close to 200 degrees. So hitting it with 50 degree water is going to shock that panel, and you got a chance of breaking your glass.
Here's another one, Matt, and go along with maintenance, storage.
So long-term storage, you want to put it away for 4 months or whatever for your winter camping season. Charge your batteries up, watch them get up, get full, hit your battery disconnect, so that shuts off all your 12 volt loads into the coach. Hit your inverter disconnect, which kills the power to the inverter. Make sure your inverter's off, and then go ahead and put it in storage.
So there's an actual switch on the inverter?
Yep. You've got your big inverter disconnect. It's labeled, it's a big red handle. Turn that off. And that'll kill the power to the inverter. Obviously, if you're storing it someplace where it's plugged in all winter long, you can leave whatever you want on, assuming you've got power. None of the disconnects that you turn off are gonna stop the solar power from charging the battery.
All right, one last question, Matt. Consumption and operating the system, knowing that you can't run forever. Is there any special tips for that?
So, again, we mentioned in this particular system, the entire coach is inverted. So you can run any outlet at any given time. Obviously you have a limit of 25 amps of what it is that you can run at a single time, but everything's available. That being said, you have to watch the consumption you have. You have 540 amp hours of battery in there. Now if I were to turn that into a lead acid, a typical lead acid probably has 60 good amp hours of usable power in it before it's too low to run. So think of that as about 9 to 10 lead acid batteries of power in there.
Wow.
That gives you a lot of runtime. However, if you're gonna try to run both air conditioners at the same time, now you're trying to pull 250 amp out of that system at a given time. So you only got about two and a half hours of runtime in there with both air conditioners running and other stuff on.
So that's where it'd be good to keep an eye on your app,
right?
Knowing how much time you got left.
Keep that app, look at it, look at your battery voltage. Lithiums are different than lead acid. So lithium batteries don't just kind of fall off you know, like a lead acid does, where it just goes, you know, 13 volts, 12, 11, 10. They just run at 13.1, 13.2 the entire time, and then they just shut off. And so the idea is watch that state of charge on your app, and that's going to tell you pretty accurately within a few minutes of when the lights are going to go out. So that's what you need to watch.
Awesome. Well, I think that covers it. So thanks for all of your knowledge today and walking us through unit. And hey, if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button below and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You could download the My Keystone app. You could visit us at keystonerv.com. And thanks for watching.